Just in case you thought that my test replacement project was over, I have one more series in my one more chapter in my series of videos here. So in my last video, I made a mistake. I went from C, which asks about the horizontal and vertical components of the velocity vectors, to E, which is what is the angle made by the velocity vector. But I forgot poor D. Oh, I'm so sorry, D. Okay, what is the magnitude of the velocity? Now, I can't, I don't discriminate. I like to answer all the subparts of the question. Remember, the question was about the projectile. So, what is the magnitude of the velocity? So, we know the horizontal and we know the vertical components. But we need to know the actual velocity. So, how do we do that? Well, moving over to my notebook. We draw a triangle. And we use trigonometry, our favorite type of math, trigonometry. So we can use the same triangle that we used for finding the angle here, 40.956 degrees. And all we do, we use Pythagorean's theorem. So if we have x as a hypotenuse, and we have our two sides, we say that a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So c, rearranging for c, solving for c, c equals, well, in this case, x. X equals square root of a squared plus b squared. And that's exactly what I did here, and I got a value of 163.914 meters per second. Now I can officially say that I'm done with my test replacement project. Ms. Leeds, I had a great time doing this. I thought your idea of having a test replacement project was a great one. So thank you so much for listening. And I'll see you in class, Ms. Leeds. Okay, bye-bye.